For centuries, it was believed that disabled people, like me, were living under a curse inflicted by God. Well, I suppose it's possible that I've upset someone up there. I prefer to think that everything can be explained another way, by the laws of nature. So what exactly is a law of nature, and why is it so powerful? I'll show you, with a game of tennis.
Tennis is governed by two sets of laws. One set is man-made, the rules of the game. They govern things such as the size of the court, the height of the net, and what determines if a shot is in or if a shot is out. These rules could conceivably be changed if the governing body of tennis so desired. But the other set of laws that apply to the game are fixed, immutable. They govern what happens to the ball when it is hit. The force and angle of the racket strike determines exactly what happens next. The laws of nature are a description of how things actually work in the past, present, and future. In tennis, the ball always goes exactly where they say it will. And there are many other laws at work here too. They govern everything that is going on, from how the energy of the shot is produced in the player's muscles, to the speed at which the grass grows beneath their feet. But what's really important is that these physical laws, as well as being unchangeable, are universal. They apply not just to the flight of a ball, but to the motion of a planet and everything else in the universe. Unlike laws made by humans, the laws of nature cannot ever be broken. That's why they are so powerful, and when seen from a religious standpoint, controversial too.